Good morning to all of you. On behalf of NIPID and Regional Centre Noida, I extend a warm welcome to all the participants to today's national webinar on role of siblings in schools with special needs. We are extremely grateful to our Director Madam, Mrs. Anuradha Dalmia Ma'am, and our Deputy Director Sir, Major V.V. Ramkumar Sir, for envisioning this concept of online national level webinars to enable us to share and upgrade our knowledge and skills in the wake of this pandemic as well. I now invite our Honorable Officer in Charge Madam, Dr. Amrita Sahai, to kindly address today's webinar.
Thank you, Anupma. Good morning, everybody. And a warm welcome to you all. It is my proud privilege to welcome our Director Madam, Mrs. Anuradha Dalmia, Director NIPID, Mr. B.V. Ramkumar, Deputy Director Sir, NIPID, all the faculty, participants and speaker of the day, Mr. Shabri Ghosh, Senior Social Worker, NIPID RC Noida. As we know that today we are connected in this webinar, which is on role of sibling. We very much aware that the sibling relationship is longest relationship than others in everyone's life and their family. Siblings play an important role in the overall development of children's understanding of others' mind, like understanding of emotion, thoughts, intentions, and belief and so on. In early childhood, we know that sibling relationships are very prominent and it is very important and overall are in our life. Children develop the intimacy among each other. Intimacy because they spend lot of time in playing together. They know each other very well, even though know their strength and weakness. It also develops the issue of power and control, as well as rivalry and jealousy, which is equally important. Not only the relationship, but birth order is also an important role in development. As we know that firstborn are usually engaged in leadership, teaching, caregiving, helping roles, and the others like second born and other are mostly they likely to imitate, like followers, and be a learner. We can utilize this beautiful relationship in the developmental process of children with special need. As we know that children with special need, if we talk about the children with special need, especially intellectual disability, they have lot of struggle. If we can utilize this beautiful relationship in the process of development, then we can minimize their struggle. I will not take much time. Mrs. Shabri Ghosh has an extensive experience in family therapy and intervention of children with special need. So I would like to invite Mrs. Shabri Ghosh, and I hope that this webinar will help us to understand the role where we can utilize this relationship to develop in the developmental process. So once again, I welcome you all in this webinar. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much, ma'am. Good morning once again to all of you, my colleagues, the participants, and my colleagues in the headquarters, especially Director Ma'am and Deputy Director Sir, very rightly said, because they've taken this initiative, we've been able to reach this position. And I'm also extremely grateful for the entire team to allow me to host this webinar. I'll not take much time in the welcoming process. That has already been very adequately done by my colleagues.
But I would like to begin with
it is our responsibility to let us introduce the eminent speaker of the day.
I'm sorry.
The this will be incomplete if we would not introduce you, your work and your experience. So the eminent speaker of the day is Mrs. Shabri Ghosh, senior social worker with NIPID Regional Center Noida. Madam has done her MSW from the Delhi University, and she has a vast experience of nearly 21 years, and she has been working with the MSEC Noida, that is Model Special Education Center Noida, with for the last 14 years, and since 5 years she has been working with the Regional Center Noida, and she is the speaker of the day who will enlighten us and share her knowledge and expertise on the role of siblings and how crucial it is in today's wake of the pandemic in supporting the children with special needs and the parents, and be a team member of rehabilitation and supportive measures. Over to you, ma'am. Please start on.
Thank you very much, Anupama. I'm sorry for the mix-up. I was a little stressed about the time that we've taken. I didn't want to waste the time with the participants as well. Again, thank you for the introduction. I think it was too lofty. Let us see what happens after the presentation. Again, welcome to all the participants. I'm hoping that a large number of parents in this program would help if somebody lets me know if I'm ready or not. As much as siblings, I mean, I would also request, especially to the parents who are listening, and if it's possible to include that sibling, the well sibling also within this presentation, that would be a good thing, because that would really help in carrying the proceedings forward. As you've already been told, the theme of today's workshop is about siblings, and here we're referring siblings to dono hai. The child with special need is also a sibling to the other sibling. So for the purpose of identification, I would like to introduce to participants that I will be using a term to refer to the sibling in concern. And here I'm referring to the sibling who is not having a special need. Jitne research material maine dekha hai, they have used two words. Both words I am not in agreement with, but nevertheless, we have to use some sort of an identification. And therefore, I'm using the word well sibling. Now, well sibling refers to the other sibling who's not having a special need, or in some other studies they have used the word typical sibling. Dono words main khilaf hoon, kyunki well sibling ka indication hai jo child with special needs hai wo well nahi hai, aur typical sibling ka matlab hai jo child with special needs wo typical nahi hai. But nevertheless, for the purpose of this interaction, it is necessary for me throughout the talk to identify whom I'm referring to, so I shall be using these two words. The second aspect I wanted to emphasize on before starting the actual presentation is the theme is the role of siblings in supporting child with special needs. So what needs to be explained here, it's not the sibling himself alone who's performing the role. The role is being performed with everybody, all the stakeholders, and it's essentially understanding the role and how this role can be groomed in such a way that he or her is able to become, grow up into an effective caretaker. Having said that, I would want to move into the introduction and objectives. Already, Dr. Amrita Sahay has very nicely briefed you about the importance of the sibling and the importance of the dynamics that happens within the family, the interplay. We've heard a lot about families coping in lockdown. बहुत सारे विषय में डिस्कशन हुआ है वेबिनार के माध्यम से और अदरवाइज ऑल्सो, एंड वी आर ऑलवेज टॉकिंग अबाउट पॉजिटिव मेंटल हेल्थ एंड रिजिलियंस एंड कोपिंग एंड ई लर्निंग एंड सो ऑन एंड सो फॉर्थ. एंड आई फील दिस इज जस्ट एज गुड टाइम, इन स्पाइट ऑफ ऑल द नेगेटिविटी अराउंड, इट्स अ गुड टाइम टू एक्सप्लोर द हिडन एस्पेक्ट्स ऑफ दिस. एंड वन हिडन एस्पेक्ट इज डेफिनेटली द सिब्लिंग. He is definitely a part of the family, but we all have to admit amongst ourselves that it's kind of a latent support, a crucial support, but a latent support, less talked about, less discussed. Even we as professional, I feel many times we tend to take things for granted. Hai to hai, so what? What is the essential role that can be performed? So essentially, what is the role can be performed, and how best can this be utilized in a positive manner? This is the layout that I'm going to be covering. I'll not get into so much detail. The slides will basically cover these areas. I've already elaborated to you about the introduction and the objectives. As you may have already seen in the flyer and in the mails that you've received, is essentially to sensitize the family to the role of sibling in the care of the special needs child, and also to sensitize them to the needs of the well sibling that we are talking about today. For a change, today we are not talking about the child with special needs. We really need to focus on the well sibling, because at the end of the discussion, I'm quite sure you'll understand this is a viable support that all of us need to groom. So in the end, I hope that we'd be able to take something back, all of us, whether you are a professional or a parent, and even the sibling, to redefine the support and the caretaking role that you all are playing in the care of the special needs child. I would like to begin with a story. If you don't mind, if somebody could please indicate if I'm still audible or not. This is a very new experience for me.
Yeah, you are audible.
Thank you. So I would like to begin with a story background. I think all of us like to hear stories at the end of the day or any time in the day. Nobody can deny that they like stories. The story I've picked up today is a very old novel written by somebody called Jyoti Picoult, which was later filmized. It was translated into a very famous and a good film called My Sister's Keeper. The aim of this story is not to drill any particular message into you. For the next 2-3 minutes, I would simply request all the participants to simply listen to the story. Please forget you're a parent. Please forget you're a sibling. Please forget you're an assistant professor. Simply listen to the story. Very small story. It's been made even shorter by me. It's focused on a young girl called Kate, who was almost after birth, she was diagnosed with leukemia, which is blood cancer. And this was a very, very rare form of leukemia that needed constant treatment protocol based on a genetic match. That means unke survival ke liye jo bhi treatment ka madhyam tha, wo is pe aadhar tha ki koi genetic, perfect genetic match chahiye toh hota usme. Now, she already has an elder brother who is not a genetic match. So the doctors advised the family, you conceive another child through IVF. And that child born through IVF is going to serve as the savior sister. Ye terms sare usi ke synopsis mein the. So ultimately the family did conceive a third child. And the third child was born through IVF. And she was named Anne, a girl. And over the next 11 years, immediately almost at birth only, she started donating things like fluid from the umbilical cord, compatible organs, blood, stem cells, tissue, etc., etc. And this went on till 11, 12 years of age. At the age when Anna was 11 and the case in concern, Kate, was 15, she suffered a kidney failure. So in a kidney failure, in a situation like this, it was obvious, the next thing even you will understand, that Anna is expected to donate her kidney. She refuses to donate her kidney. She feels that she's done some research and she feels, no, my life is not going to be normal after kidney donation. I'm not going to be able to do the things that my friends do. I'm not able to get married. Even if I do get married, I'd have to be very careful about what I eat, what I do, how I have children, and generally. So she puts her foot down at the age of 11 and she refuses to go ahead with the kidney donation. Now you can obviously imagine the impact it must have had on the mother who had planned this baby only for the sake of saving the elder child. And she was completely shocked, the result being that the younger sibling, the well sibling that we're talking about, she filed a court case for medical emancipation, and she, through the court case, she's trying to get her rights for her own body, and she's also trying to partially terminate the rights of her parents on her body. It's a very unusual situation. Shayad India mein aise sunne mein nahi aayenge aapko, but this is a very common situation in a country like the US. But like I said, hum log details ke andar nahi ghusenge. Abhi current sthiti aise hai. The story ends on a very, very strange kind of a note where we find that the elder sibling eventually passes away. She is unable to continue with her fight with cancer. She dies. And after the death, it is discovered that the sibling who had filed the case, she won the case that she was filed in court. Now, this is where I would like to end the story. Whatever happens in between is, of course, not as important. But what is right now more important is some reactions your thoughts. What you think about the story? What do you think Anne would have had to go through? What the elder sibling who had blood cancer, what she would have had to go through? What the parents must have gone through? As a matter of fact, the family was torn apart when all this was happening. The father was on the side of the well sibling. The mother was on the other side where she wanted to save her daughter with cancer, and so on and so forth. This story is not reflective of what is happening in your families. It is not reflective at all. The only reason I've shared this story is to get a reflection of some of the undercurrents which are related to this topic and undercurrents which are related to the sibling relationship, which is the core of this topic. So this is not a lecture. I would like to again reiterate before I go on to the next slide. This is not a lecture of any kind. Ye entire jo talk hai, ye sirf ek scope hai, ek madhyam hai, jisse ab hum sab introspect kare, hum apne apne roles kya nibhayenge, aage jaake kya ho sakta hai in relationships mein. Now siblings, without going into too much introduction, I think we already understand that it's one of the most lasting and enduring bonds of family relationships, something that lasts a lifetime. Whether you have a child with special needs or not, the bond with your brother and sister will go beyond the bond with your parents, because obviously your parents will not be there for a lifetime, but your siblings are going to likely to be there for a lifetime since they are the same generation. It's a very, very special bond, and they are an integral part of the family support system. They experience all the feelings that parents experience while dealing with a special child. But the only difference is, in many cases, they do not have a voice where they can express themselves, or where you can see their sorrow, or where you can see the feelings that they're going through. And therefore, it is extremely important to pay attention. They suffer largely because of the time and attention and money that is given to the care of the child with special need. But the well siblings' reactions to the sibling with a disability affects both the lives, the lives of the child with special needs and also with the well sibling himself. And therefore, the bottom line is, it's equally important to give much attention to the well sibling as much as we are giving to the child with special needs. I hope the message is very clear, that I'm not intending this to be a lecture at all, but I would request all the participants to keep on thinking about what is reflected. They can, of course, disagree, because everybody has a different story in a different position. The point I'm trying to make here is, apart from being a lasting and enduring parental relationship, we need to remember that the siblings are also most likely the ones who are going to become the caretakers in the future, in the care of the child with special needs, who's ultimately going to become an adult. And what we have frequently seen is, in that struggle to rehabilitate, or the struggle to bring the family to a middle line of normalcy, that is sometimes prevalent, and that unfortunately takes over all the time and attention within the house, as a result of which many times, I did not say always, but many times the typical sibling is neglected. And when the neglect becomes emotional, and when the neglect becomes for a prolonged period of time, it has effects which may not be positive on the long run. Long run se matlab hai mere, 20-25 saal baad ap expect kare ki ye aage aake inka role nibhaye, ye thoda sa mushkil type lag raha hai situation mein. So that is what we are trying to explore. The opposite might also be true. You might also have very, very balanced people who are willing to give equal attention to the well sibling as well, and ensure that he grows in a healthy manner. So what is the impact of all this that is happening with the child with special needs? What is the impact on the typical sibling? That's what we need to understand. So what I'm essentially trying to say is, maybe at some point in time, we need to understand that maybe parents, professionals, and the entire system needs to be more sensitive to create a balance in meeting the needs of these well siblings, and also helping them to understand their ultimate role. I mean, what at the end of the day, if the well sibling stands up and says, no, I'm not interested in looking after him or her. I would like to find a home where he can be put away, and that is as far as my needs go. What are you going to do about it? The fact is, there's actually very little that you can do about it. But naturally, in the Indian situation, we do expect these kinds of things to happen, where a sibling will obviously come forward and take up the role of a caretaker. Now, I would like to focus a little on the psychosocial perspectives also of the well sibling. Like I've said, it could be a 50-50 situation. I'm not saying that it's always negative. We have seen a lot of positive cases in our professional work. But by and large, where even where there is apparent positivity, we find quite a few instances of what I have listed in this slide that you can see, where there is a lot of disruption in education and restrictions in education. अब ये चीज विलिंगली किया गया है या अनविलिंगली किया गया है दैट विल डिफर फ्रॉम केस टू केस बट नेवरदलेस दिस इंस्टेंसेस आर वेरी कॉमन वेल सिब्लिंग्स आर ऑफन इनडायरेक्टली और डायरेक्टली आस्क्ड टू कॉम्प्रोमाइज इन रिक्रिएशन दे आर नॉट एबल टू गो आउट एंड हैव अ गुड टाइम विद फ्रेंड्स फ्रीक्वेंटली द वे अदर फैमिलीज डू दे अल्टीमेटली रिसीव लेस अटेंशन बिकॉज नेचुरली द चाइल्ड विद स्पेशल नीड्स हैज ट्रेमेंडस डिमांड फॉर अटेंशन एंड multi-pronged approach from different sides, different things are happening. From therapeutic side, something is happening. School admission, another thing is happening. Medical issues, something else is happening. So as a result, the net attention becomes obviously less. They face a great deal of social ridicule, a great deal of exclusion and isolation, especially in school situations and in peer group situations. There are added responsibilities, of course, they have to play in the 24-hour schedule. That is something they cannot escape from when you are staying in the same house. The emotional reactions, of course, can be very, very strong on the positive side and on the negative side. That you will understand a little forward as we talk about the examples. And the most pronounced thing that I find is the worry for the future. And that is something I find prevalent in siblings who are, let's say, 18 plus. That when they start thinking about their own future, they also start worrying about the siblings' future. How do the two things meet? How do I carry on my career? And how do I make sure that he's looked after? Do I sacrifice my marriage? Even if I get married, can I have children? ऐसे तो नहीं है जो बच्चे मेरे पैदा होंगे वे ऐसे ही निकले या बच्चे भी पैदा हुआ ऐसे तो नहीं है कि ये उनके ऊपर बुरा प्रभाव पड़े बुरा इम्पैक्ट पड़े. Having said that, I would also like to finish off this slide by emphasizing there is also a lot of positive effects we see. By positive effects, what immediately comes to my mind is by fine siblings who are so proactive in the care of their siblings with special need. They enter into professional courses, they get trained as rehabilitation professionals, they work as rehabilitation professionals, and I believe that brings a completely different impact on caring for the person with special needs, which is a very, very positive impact. You might argue that means wo sara apne career chhod ke ya apne interest chhod ke isi line mein ghus jaye taki wo sara life is pe sacrifice kare. Well, that is one perspective you might have. Another perspective is they may find it rewarding enough to get into this kind of a role. So nevertheless, these are some of the psychosocial aspects that I meant to share with you. I would like to share some of the case examples without which I think this talk would really be incomplete. But before I share that, I was wondering, Anupama, can we go for just one poll right now? Hello, Anupama. Rahul ji, can we go for a poll right now? Okay, so I'm glad that we're on track. May I continue now? That was the results of the poll. In a family having a child with special needs, whose needs are more important? It's very rewarding to see that most of you have exercised that everybody's needs are important, whether it is the child with special needs, the well sibling, and of course the parents. Okay, I would like to return to the presentation, if I may be permitted to do so. Once more, if I may please ask if I'm audible or not.
Yes, ma'am, you are audible.
Thank you so much. Like I was saying, I would like to put a very quick case examples that typically come across in the setting that we are working with. As you know, NIPID is one of the prime assessment centers that we have, where we cater to the entire of Delhi and NCR region, North India.
Please go on full screen mode, please.
Full screen mode, sorry.
Yeah, slideshow mode, please.
Yeah. Fine?
Yes, ma'am, it's fine.
Fine, thank you. So, one of the very, very typical things that we find in our setting is young typical siblings contributing amazing information into the behavior, the likes and the dislikes and challenges of the special needs siblings. When we take up a case, we are expected to do a case history. And as I'm sure most of the parents are aware, if they have gone to any center for assessment, is we have to take a detailed case history, which includes everything and anything. And when it comes to information about the child with special needs, it is amazing the range of information they're able to volunteer with, even before the parent volunteers the information. Sometimes I find parents taking time to understand what I'm trying to say. And within a fraction of a second, you get instantaneous and very, very natural answers from the a young sibling who has accompanied the family. And sometimes they're very difficult questions also. But they seem to have the information ready on their hard drives, and they come up with their likes and dislikes, their behavior problems, their challenges, and their reactions, and so on and so forth. And even those siblings in the same age bracket as the child with special needs, they're found to contribute much more to the ADL and the caregiving activities than the parents do. Now, I am amazed simply because of the age of the children, where we expect that they're immature and they would not understand anything, because a child as young as 6 or 7 is barely aware of his own needs, let alone meeting the needs of a person with special needs. But even then, they're able to do an amazing work. And I'm sure my colleagues will agree here. Another typical situation that we've come across, maybe not so typical, but quite a number of cases we have seen, where the child with special needs is considered lucky for the family. Because when he was born, apparently the parents narrate that I've been very lucky with a promotion, a new job, a new house, we acquired property, and so on and so forth. So we consider him to be very lucky, and therefore we are willing to do everything for him, well and good. But sadly, in the process, like I explained a few minutes back, the well sibling faced rejection in this process, very sadly. He faced adversity. In spite of the rejection and the adversity, the sort of a passion to do something for himself. And we find that such persons excelled in his or her chosen profession. Now, you might ask, parents must be wondering, agar aapko pata hai ki is tarah se rejection face kar rahe, to kyun ne aap logo ne highlight kiya is cheez ko, ne definitely highlight kiya. But like I said, with parents, we are not here to give lectures, and in our settings also, we do not give lectures. We have to see each and every family separately with their individual needs and perspectives and sociology and psychology. So even after we have brought this to the notice of parents, there is not everything that you can change. But nevertheless, this is one example that we've come across. Another typical example we've come across again is very, very young siblings mothering the child with special needs, which is such a rare instinctive care and nurture that it's really a pleasure to see and a blessing to see that without having had to do anything at all, they are transiting naturally into the role of a caretaker. And we've actually seen this happening in day-to-day situations.
Ghosh ma'am, if yes. You can please make your audio a little more clear. Is it's getting echoed to many of the participants.
Okay. I'm using headphones. Shall I remove the headphones?
Maybe you can try that.
Okay. Is that slightly better now? Is that slightly better now?
Actually, the voice is better with us, but the participants are giving the feedback. So let's try without headphones, and if it will be better, I'll get the feedback.
Okay.
And we'll let
you. So shall I repeat the previous slide?
Maybe. The previous slide can be repeated, please.
I was referring, I'm extremely sorry for the echo, but I expect somebody or the other is probably unmuted. If I can ask the participants to check that you're unmuted so we can continue. What I was essentially trying to say here is we find very, very frequent instances where siblings come forward and play a very constructive role right from the time form assessment, where some questions are being put up related to the behavior of the child with special needs, even before the parents volunteer the information. The very young siblings are able to quickly explain to you exactly in detail what information that you require. And I expect that is probably because they contribute far more in areas of ADL and caregiving activities sometimes. And they have probably a natural affinity. And maybe it is because of the result of the bonding or the result of the care that the parents have given both the siblings that they're able to contribute so constructively. And one or two other typical situations I wanted to present. One is, like I've said before, is frequently we find the child with special needs is considered as a lucky charm for the family. According to them, their explanation is that just after he was born, we found a lot of changes. Some prosperity or some acquiring of property, some profession, some promotion in job or some new job, a higher paying job, things which were very positive. So as a result, the child with special needs was no doubt viewed as very lucky and positive. But as a probably as a corollary to this or as a consequence of this, I really can't say is the well sibling faced tremendous rejection, faced adversity, but they also faced some sort of, they had some sort of a passion to excel and do well in their profession, which is again, ultimately very positive. But then it's also a question as to whether this is permissible or not, whether it's acceptable or not. Another typical situation you find is very, very young siblings mothering the child with special needs with some sort of an instinctive care and nurture, and ultimately taking them towards a gradual transition to become a natural caretaker in the future. In adulthood, also again, another different aspect, another different part of your life cycle is where some families show the rejection of the special needs sibling by the other sibling, blaming the special needs sibling for his or her failed relationships, not able to get married, not able to settle down. And wanting the special needs sibling to be put away in a home. Sad as it sounds, this frequently happens. Again, here I want to pause to emphasize that this is not a sermon, this is not a pravachan that you should do this or you should not do this. It is simply a mode where I would request participants to do a little bit of introspection on what is currently happening and whether there's anything more that can be done or whether something is missing that can probably be brought into your support system where the well sibling is concerned. So as an adult, on the other hand, the last case situation I wanted to present, which is again is very, very common to us at least. We find as an adult, many willing to give up their own personal lives. They're willing to give up marriage for the sake of care of their special needs sibling because they feel they can't really pull the two wheels together. One wheel is getting married, settling down, having a family, and the other hand is looking after the special needs sibling. Now, I would just leave it to the reflection of the people who are listening to me right now is how justified you think this is. you think this is the right thing to do, you think this is should be not be done, you think he should be encouraged, no, he's got to get married and settle down and have a family. What? There are different perspectives. I don't want to provide any answers because I don't believe there are any specific answers. I might have my own views, but I would really, really like the participants to think and reflect on this aspect. This is a very, very important aspect. May I continue, or is there any question, Anupama, any comment you would want to add, anything in the question and answer box?
You may please continue, ma'am.
Now, the next aspect I wanted to bring to the light is this question about how to explain. This is something which is very, very perplexing. And to be very, very honest to all the participants, sometimes we professionals also tend to bypass this and go on to something more within our comfort zone. But it is something that has to be faced. Just like sexuality, something we don't talk about very often, but we know that it's got to face. So this is also something we have to be face is how do we explain this situation? You need to understand that the impact of the disabled child on the well sibling changes over time. A very young child will have one kind of concern, one kind of reaction. A child who's going to school or an adolescent well sibling will have a different set of concerns, different set of needs, different set of reactions. And likewise, an adult, of course, will have different reactions. But the question, how do we explain, is a very, very crucial question. And we need to reflect a little bit on it. I am sure that we have parents who have done this extremely well. We are not doubting your capabilities at all. But maybe some others also need to reflect on this. The key principle, there are two key principles in this. One key principle is that the younger the child, the more difficult it is maybe to understand the situation and explain things to him and how he will respond. And the second key principle, which comes a little later in the slide, is that the parent's acceptance is very crucial when you are explaining this to the child. Agar parents ke andar kuch duvida hai, kuch confusion hai, kuch bhedbhav hai ke andar ya kuch conflict hai mind mein regarding the situation, regarding the disability, then it becomes more difficult to explain to a small child about what is happening. So the impact, like I've said, changes over time. Now, before I continue, I am keeping the slide open intentionally. Before I continue, I'd like to narrate a very, very small case example that came across to us about a few months ago before the lockdown. Is of a somewhat hyperactive child with autism who was experienced some sort of aggression within himself and with the people around him as well. And he was brought to our place for intervention, and the mother was interacting with me, and she happened to have sibling, a young girl, a daughter accompanying her. And at that time, there was some altercation between the well sibling and the sister in concern. And she narrated that, "Madam, how do I handle this at home? It becomes so difficult. I keep on trying to explain to this little one that you've got to adjust, you've got to accommodate." So the little one's question was, "Mama, why doesn't he play with me? Why does he hit me? Even when I don't do anything, he hits me." So she constantly tried to justify that she explains to the little one to accept. So my question to her was, when was the last time you actually hugged the little one? When was the last time you made her sit next to you and touch her and give her special time for herself only, not for the sake of this other one? Of course, I do understand that a large amount of time you have to give. Usme koi shak ki baat nahi hai. But is bachchi ke saath kitna apne gale kab lagaya last? And of course, she did not have a specific answer to give. And she's explained that she's so occupied with the other one. Ki obviously, I schools other time. So there and then I asked her in front of me, there was nobody else in the room. I said, "You pull her close and give her a very tight hug," which she did. My only intention of doing this was to explain to the parent that before you start explaining things to her, you've got to accept her as well as a separate individual, different from this child with a special need. Everything in your life now is an extension of this child with the special needs. What you do, what you eat, what time you sleep, your activity for the day, your routine for the day, everything is around him. But this child is a living being. She's another being that has come into your family and she has a separate position. And therefore, that recognition is necessary. Simply by making her sit down and telling her, I love you and you're also important to me, is not a form of recognition. The expression is also important. And after you accept her, take her into confidence, give her a separate position, then you need to explain that, yes, your brother's different. He's got certain issues. We are working on these issues. You need to help whenever you can. With the preschool child, and this is a preschool child I was referring to, there is a lot of confusion, there's a lot of fear, anxiety, and sometimes anger also. There might be imitation. There might be some situations where they will try to act very small, as if they need that attention the way a baby asks for attention. There could be, unfortunately, extremes of behavior like acting out or throwing a temper tantrum, or on the other hand, becoming so perfect that it's almost too perfect to be true. तो ये जब reactions होते हैं ये जाहिर सी बात है the parents do need to stop and think what's going wrong, what have I done wrong, am I actually giving that importance to this child as I'm giving to the other. As we move down into school, things become a little worse if things are not positive. मैं बार बार कह रही हूँ things could be positive also, but if they're positive, well and good. If they're negative, this is where we have to sit and think. So school-going children, on account of the child with special needs, are likely to go through a great deal of shame, embarrassment, teasing. And you know how school children are. I don't have to get into that. There's also a great sense of comparison with their peer. Unki ghar mein kya hota hai, meetings mein kaun aata hai, kis tarah se lifestyle hota hai, picnics jaate hai, movies jaate hai, etc., etc. In any case, that comparison is there. And now it becomes worse if there's a child with special needs. So there's a sense of protectiveness also that they experience. For that reason, we frequently try as much as possible when we are working with families who are having just a single child, and that single child is the one with a disability. It's often advisable for professionals to advise to plan a second child. Now, not the second child in the sense that related to the story that I first narrated about being a sister's keeper, not for the sake of having a caretaker in the future, but for the sake of giving a normal, healthy interaction for the child with special needs who needs a companion for that point of view. Of course, I want that.
Ma'am, can we go bilingual way as well?
Bilingual?
Yeah.
Okay, I'll try. I request you to continue when you feel in.
The voice quality and echoing is perfectly fine at our end.
So I'm saying I'm requesting you to continue the translation wherever possible.
Ma'am, please repeat.
For the translation, you are suggesting that I go bilingual, right?
While you are delivering the lecture, few of the participants are requesting that if Hindi and English can be mixed up.
Yes, so I will do that. But I request you to continue where you can continue.
Okay, ma'am. Sure.
Yeah. Okay. In that case, I will quickly repeat the previous slide. यहाँ पर हम उस विषय में बात करें जिसमें स्कूल गोइंग बच्चे जो वेल सिबलिंग है जो जिस सिबलिंग के अंदर कोई दिक्कत नहीं है जो स्कूल गोइंग बच्चे हैं उनमें एक अलग किस्म के प्रॉब्लम्स दिखाई देते हैं जो खुद को जुटना होता है बहुत तरह की टीजिंग चलता है स्कूल में छेड़छाड़ होता है जबकि मालूम होता है कि बच्चे या भाई बहन ऐसे हैं तो उस तरह से एक टीजिंग या कंपैरिजन शुरू हो जाता है एक डिफेंसिवनेस भी हो जाता है कि अगर कोई उस भाई बहन के बारे में उल्टे सीधे बोले तो उस तरह से एक रिएक्शन होना और एक तरह से एक अजीब सा आइसोलेशन पैदा हो जाता है जिसमें अकेले रहना शुरू करते हैं या सिर्फ दो तीन पीयर दो तीन खास दोस्त हो जाए तो वही बहुत है बहुत अच्छा ये चीज नहीं है क्योंकि अल्टीमेटली आपके कॉन्फिडेंस पे असर अगर होता है तो जाहिर सी बात है पढ़ाई के ऊपर भी असर होता है इसी वजह से हम जो परिवार में हम देखते हैं कि सिर्फ एक सिंगल बच्चा है जो कि खुद स्पेशल नीड्स बच्चा है स्पेशल बच्चा है या डिसेबल्ड बच्चे है जो ऑलरेडी दिक्कत महसूस कर रहे हैं फैमिली में हम थोड़ा सा हिंट करके या थोड़ा सा इंडिकेशन इस चीज पे भी देते कि दूसरा बच्चा भी प्लान करे इस वजह से दूसरा बच्चा प्लान करना नहीं है जो आगे जाके केयरटेकर बने, नॉट फॉर दैट पर्सपेक्टिव ओनली, पर इस मकसद से भी प्लानिंग करना जरूरी है कि जो सिंगल बच्चा पल रहे उनके लिए एक सोशलाइजेशन का माध्यम या एक सपोर्ट का माध्यम बने ड्यूरिंग हिज ग्रोइंग ईयर्स। आगे जाके दिक्कत और बढ़ जाते हैं, सिचुएशन की वजह से बढ़ जाते हैं जब हम यंग अडल्ट्स की बात करते हैं। यंग अडल्ट से मतलब है 18 प्लस, जहां पर अपने करियर में सेटल होना शुरू करना, अपने शादी के बारे में आगे जाके जैसे 25 साल तक आप पहुंच गए तो शादी के बारे में ध्यान देना है, खुद शादी और मे बी स्पेशल नीड्स का भी शादी का मन में सोचे, कोई कह नहीं सकते। शादी के बाद भी किस तरह का एडजस्टमेंट करना है, कैसे करना है, अपना शादी के बाद जो बच्चे के प्लानिंग हो उसमें जेनेटिक काउंसलिंग करे ना करे, कैसे करे। और सबसे महत्वपूर्ण सबसे नीचे लिखा है कि जो आगे जाके जो ध्यान है, जो एंजाइटी है, जो टेंशन है, वो रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी, दोनों चीज कैसे एक लाइन पे लाए। एक चीज है स्पेशल नीड्स सिबलिंग का देखभाल और दूसरा है अपने जिंदगी का देखभाल। जैसे आपको याद होगा तो कुछ स्लाइड्स पहले मैंने जिक्र किया था, कुछ ऐसे भी एडल्ट्स मिलता है जिसमें वो तय कर लेते कि अपने शादी करना ही नहीं है, बस पूरे जिंदगी इस बच्चे के पीछे लगाना है, यही हमारा प्रेरणा है, यही हमारा जीवन है, यही सब कुछ है। और तभी मैंने एक प्रश्न उठाया था, रिक्वेस्ट किया था ये ध्यान में रख के रिफ्लेक्ट करे इस चीज को कि क्या जब ऐसे कोई आते हैं आपके सामने, कोई भी हो सकते हैं, आपके पड़ोस भी हो सकते हैं, आपके दूर के रिश्तेदार भी हो सकते हैं, या प्रोफेशंस के लिए आपके कोई केस हो सकता है जिसमें आके आपके सामने ये डिक्लेयर करता है कि मैंने तो तय कर लिया मैं शादी नहीं करूंगा, शादी नहीं करूंगी, यही इसी के साथ में पूरे जिंदगी मुझे रहना है और देखभाल करना है, आप क्या कहेंगे उसको, व्हाट वुड योर पर्सपेक्टिव बी। इसमें कोई एक फिक्स्ड आंसर या कोई जनरल आंसर देना बहुत मुश्किल है, इट इज सिंपली नॉट पॉसिबल। सबका पर्सपेक्टिव अलग है, सबके नीड्स अलग है, सबके सिचुएशन अलग है, मेरा सिचुएशन भी अलग है, मेरे भी एक पर्सपेक्टिव है इसके बारे में। एट द मोस्ट यू कैन प्रोबेबली सजेस्ट, यस एज अ प्रोफेशनल आई वुड सजेस्ट दैट नो दिस मे नॉट बी द राइट थिंग फॉर यू, क्योंकि आपके शादी से ही द स्पेशल नीड सिबलिंग इज गोइंग टू गेट अ फैमिली विद इन विच टू लिव एंड अ फैमिली विद इन विच टू फंक्शन। तो ना चाहते हुए मैंने आंसर दे दिया, लेकिन ये मेरे पर्सपेक्टिव है, हो सकते हैं आपके अंदर कुछ और पर्सपेक्टिव हो। मैं एक्सप्लेनेशन की बात कर रही थी कि इस चीज को बच्चे को कैसे एक्सप्लेन करें। तो एक्सप्लेन करने से पहले ये नीचे के दो प्रश्न है उस पर थोड़ा सा ध्यान दे। बिफोर एक्सप्लेनिंग ऑनेस्टली यू हैव टू थिंक एंड टेल, नॉट बिकॉज आई एम गिविंग यू दिस स्लाइड एंड आई एम गिविंग यू दिस आइडिया, डू यू थिंक दैट द वेल सिबलिंग डिजर्व्स एन एक्सप्लेनेशन और नॉट। क्या जो अच्छा सिबलिंग है जिसके अंदर कोई दिक्कत नहीं है, क्या उसका कोई एक्सप्लेनेशन का हकदार है वो? शुड ही गेट एन एक्सप्लेनेशन और नॉट? इफ यू थिंक दैट ही शुड नॉट गेट एन एक्सप्लेनेशन, वो तो फिर कहानी वही खत्म हो जाते हैं एंड यू डील विद द कॉन्सिक्वेंसेस। बट इफ यू थिंक ही डिजर्व्स एन एक्सप्लेनेशन देन डेफिनेटली वन हैज टू गेट इनटू इट। और पेरेंट्स से बेहतर, माँ बाप से बेहतर कोई और नहीं है जो ये चीज को एक्सप्लेन कर सकते हैं। And this last question is always there in the mind of each and every parent. Will he or she look after her? Jab hum nahi rahenge, kya iska dekhbhal ye karega ya karegi ya nahi? It's a very tough question. Another reflection point I have brought here, because when we rush through the lecture, we forget that these points are also important. So I simply wanted to leave you with it. Bas ye dhyan mein ye lekar ab jaye. वेबिनार से और बाद में सोचे इसके बारे में कि वाकई में जो वेल सिबलिंग है उसका मन में क्या होता है जब वो समझना शुरू होता है कि कुछ तो गड़बड़ है, समथिंग इज नॉट राइट, समथिंग इज नॉट द वे इट शुड बी। नॉट बिकॉज मम्मी एंड पापा आर क्राइंग और नॉट बिकॉज देयर इज अ वेरी सैड सिचुएशन इन द हाउस, पर उस बच्चे के प्रति जो उसका ऑब्जर्वेशन है, ही फील्स दैट समथिंग इज नॉट राइट। सो हैव वी रियली ट्राई टू अंडरस्टैंड व्हाट हैपेंस इन हिज माइंड? Could be a range of reactions, बहुत तरह के reactions हो सकते हैं। मैं negative नहीं बोल रही हूँ, positive भी हो सकते हैं, हो सकते एक sense of protectiveness जाग जाए उसके अंदर। So that sense of protectiveness is what we really need to understand what is happening. Like I said, सबसे पहले मैंने कहा था कि जब तक पेरेंट्स का स्वीकृति ना हो, जब तक एक्सेप्टेंस ना हो पेरेंट्स का, ये आंसर देना असंभव है। आंसर तो आप दे दोगे लेकिन हो सकता है उस तरह का इम्पैक्ट ना हो। इफ द पेरेंट इज नॉट एक्सेप्टिंग द सिचुएशन, ही इज लाइकली टू प्रोजेक्ट, आई थिंक लाइकली टू प्रोजेक्ट समथिंग नेगेटिव और समथिंग नॉट ऑप्टिमिस्टिक, कुछ खराब दिशा में डायरेक्शन वो जा सकते हैं। तो पेरेंटल एक्सेप्टेंस बहुत इम्पोर्टेंट है। और जब चीज कोई एक्सप्लेन करे, आप ध्यान रखिएगा ऑल द पार्टिसिपेंट्स, स्पेशली द पेरेंट्स, जब आप डॉक्टर से पूछने गए थे या जब जिस टाइम आपको कहा गया था कि बच्चा ऐसे रहेगा या ऐसे स्थिति है, वो ऑनेस्टी आपने ढूंढा, वो सच्चाई ढूंढा उनकी बातों में। सो इन द सेम मैनर इट इज इम्पॉर्टेंट दैट वेन पेरेंट्स आर एक्सप्लेनिंग द सिचुएशन टू सिबलिंग्स, दे हैव टू बी ऑनेस्ट अबाउट वॉट इज बींग सेड विदाउट लाइंग अबाउट इट। And secondly, information giving is very important. Giving the correct information and also understanding the sibling. Can I please request another poll? Rahul ji, can we have another poll? अच्छा नहीं है, हाँ आगे नहीं देंगे, बंद कर दिया। ओके 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 ठीक है ठीक है। Okay, if I can please continue. I'd like to continue with the presentation. Hello, am I audible, please?
Yes, ma'am.
Right, thank you. I'm continuing here with, now since we are talking about the well sibling, सिर्फ उसी sibling के बारे में बात करें, हम समझे तो उसे, उसके needs क्या है, उसके ज़रूरतें क्या है, कि जब ये सारे talk के विषय का जो main aspect है वो यूं है कि उनका needs क्या है, किस तरह से उनकी needs हम समझे और पूरा करें। The first need and obviously the most important need is acceptance. और यहाँ हम किस चीज के acceptance की बात कर रहे हैं, हम CWSN के acceptance की बात नहीं कर रहे, हम इसी sibling के बारे में बात कर रहे, जीता जागता इंसान जो आपके सामने है उसको भी उतना acceptance और प्यार देना जितना आपने उसको दिया है। Issue is not necessarily that he has to have a problem to be accepted. He needs to be accepted for what he is. जिस तरह से आप respect किसी और को देते, प्यार किसी और को देते, परिवार के किसी भी सदस्य को, उस तरह से उतना importance उसको मिलना चाहिए, चाहे वो 2 साल का बच्चा हो या 20 साल का adult हो। Recognition for his individuality is another thing. And बीच में आपने देखा है, box में मैंने permission शब्द circle किया है। परमिशन शब्द इसलिए सर्कल किया है कि समटाइम्स वी आर वेरी वेरी अग्रेसिव एंड वेरी क्रिटिकल अबाउट हिज रिएक्शंस, वी क्रिटिकल अबाउट द नेगेटिव रिएक्शंस कमिंग इन फ्रॉम अनदर पर्सन। सो इन परमिशन व्हिच इज अ फॉर्म ऑफ थेरेपी यूज्ड इन वन एस्पेक्ट ऑफ साइकोलॉजी, आई एम नॉट गेटिंग इन टू द थेरेपी पार्ट, पर कभी कभार इस चीज को भी आप, हम एज फैमिलीज एंड एज प्रोफेशनल्स, हम लोग एक्सेप्ट करें कि अगर उसको गुस्सा आता है, इट्स ओके टू बी एंग्री, It's okay to feel bad about yourself. It's okay not to want to play with your sibling. It's okay to spend time with your friends. And it's also okay to be guilty for some of the time. तो ये इस वजह से हम एम्फेसाइज कर रहे हैं कि कई बार एक गिल्ट पैदा होता है इंसान के अंदर, सिबलिंग्स के अंदर, कि मुझे पता है घर पे प्रॉब्लम्स है, आई एम सपोज टू सपोर्ट बट आई एम नॉट सपोर्टिंग. मुझे मन कर रहा है कि वो दोस्त के साथ जाके खेलूं, लेकिन जब मैं जाता हूँ दोस्त के साथ वापस जाके, मुझे बहुत बुरा फील होता है कि मैंने मम्मी पापा को सपोर्ट नहीं किया. सो इन ऑर्डर टू रेक्टिफाई दीज गिल्ट्स एंड दीज नेगेटिव इमोशंस, इज इम्पोर्टेंट टू गिव परमिशन फ्रॉम टाइम टू टाइम that it is okay to be you. I will again leave these two questions just as reflection. Is ye pura bond up fir se soche ki pure parivar ka jo santulan hai usko kaise impact karte hain, kis tarah ka prabhav padta hai. Prabhav zarur padta hai, ye aap na soche ki isko bhi hum thode din aur nazar andaaz kare, bas bachcha theek ho jaye fir uske upar dhyan de. Is tarah se situation nahi hota hai. Lockdown. Everybody is talking about the lockdown. There's a lot of stress related to the lockdown. Lot of experiences related to the lockdown. Again, हम negative के बारे में नहीं सोचेंगे. ये चार जो circles हैं, उस circles पे ध्यान रखिएगा. ये एक ऐसे time है जिसमें बहुत सारे चीज़ आप कर सकते हैं जो आप नहीं कर पाए before. So, with respect to the current talk, my request again, this is not a lecture. This is only a platform for introspection. Please think. Please focus on the insights that you are gaining from this talk, of insights that you are gaining from other families, and think the introspection part. बहुत गौर से सोचे और बहुत objectively सोचे कि ये कोई और परिवार होता तो हम कैसे respond करते, हम क्या कहते. मेरे परिवार के बारे में कहना बहुत बहुत मुश्किल है और change लाना भी बहुत मुश्किल होता है. तो इस चीज को हम objectivity कहते हैं. थोड़ा सा objectivity के साथ introspect करके धीरे से चेंज लाना शुरू करें, और चेंज के साथ साथ डेफिनेटली आपके मन में एक नया डेफिनेशन पैदा हो सकता है. सो माय ओनली रिक्वेस्ट इज टू यूज दिस लॉकडाउन एंड एक्सपीरियंस. मुझे नहीं पता आपके परिवार में क्या हो रहा है, लेकिन हम यहाँ बैठे बैठे घर पे वो चीज हम देख पा रहे हैं लॉकडाउन में, जो चीज हम क्लिनिक सिचुएशन में अपने संस्था में हम नहीं देख पाए. वी डिड नॉट एवर सी द रिएक्शन ऑफ द सिबलिंग्स टुवर्ड्स देयर disabled siblings, the way they are making effort to join in the activities, to complete the activities, to support them. And there's one particular girl I remember, without giving names, I don't remember her name, ki us apne bhai behan bhai ke sath jo activity diya gaya tha, father was busy in the photography part, so she was encouraging the child in such a beautiful and almost professional way. Ab yakeen nahi manenge, us bachchi ne shayad, she's maybe around 8 or 9 years old, she did not do any physical prompting with the other child. She just kept on giving instructions, encouraging him to do complete, very good, shabash. Ek bhi bar usne touch nahi kiya, lekin physically saath baitha aur encourage karte gayi. So this may not be the situation everywhere, but I feel this is a model situation that we need, all of us need to learn from. And likewise, we have seen the involvement and the curiosity and the passion and the interest that is shown by siblings. This is the time where parents can really encourage that. हाँ, एक टाइम में आपको महसूस होगा आपका तो टाइम वेस्ट हो रहा है, आपका भी तो वर्क फ्रॉम होम है, कितना टाइम आपको देना पड़ता है ऑफिस में, पर ये ऐसे मौका शायद दोबारा आपको नहीं मिलेंगे. एंड इट इज अ वे ऑफ सीमेंटिंग द क्लोजनेस दिस इन द रिलेशनशिप. द वे आई वुड लाइक यू टू सी इट, एंड हियर आई विल से यस दिस इज अ लेक्चर, is the sibling relationship, or rather the sibling in concern, the well sibling, is somewhere in between this arrow. Upar wala arrow aap dekhenge, rejection or acceptance ke beech mein kahin na kahin jarur aata hai. Agar acceptance ke taraf hai to bahut achhi, agar rejection ke taraf hai tab bhi koi harz nahi hai, aap abhi bhi kaam kar sakte hain. Again, another continuum is the non-adjustment and adjustment. It is hoped that with the effort that you make, जिस तरह से आप encourage कर रहे हैं, जिस तरह से चारों तरफ से information मिल रहा है, it is quite possible that there will be a period of a non-adjustment. But gradually, if you want, you can make it very positive and he can move towards the adjustment. So the basic idea is जहाँ पर वो आपको लगता है इस continuum में, इस line के ऊपर जहाँ वो पड़ता है वो sibling, आप धीरे धीरे adjustment और acceptance की तरफ आप ले जा सकते हैं. लेकिन वो तब मुमकिन होगा जब primary caregiver, मतलब माता पिता खुद अगर acceptance पे पहुंच सकते हैं.
Now how can I decide? मुझे कैसे पता होगा कि ये कौन से स्थिति में है, किस सिचुएशन में है? It's very highly objective. मैं पोजीशन साइड में नहीं बता पाऊंगी, लेकिन मैं कुछ फैक्टर्स आपको जरूर बता पाऊंगी जिससे ये कंटिन्यूम में एडजस्टमेंट के तरफ जाए या एक्सेप्टेंस के तरफ जाए. वन इज ऑफ कोर्स द बर्थ पोजीशन. जैसे अमृता मैम ने शुरू में ही बताया था कि एल्डर सिबलिंग जो है ज्यादातर लीडरशिप पोजीशंस या पावर पोजीशंस में आता है, लेकिन ये जरूरी नहीं है कि हमेशा एल्डर के साथ है, यंग के साथ भी हो सकता है डिपेंडिंग ऑन द अदर फैक्टर्स. फैमिली रिसोर्सेस कितना है, स्ट्रेसेस कितना है फैमिली का खुद का क्षमता कितना है, लड़ने का क्षमता कितना है, कोप करने का क्षमता कितना है, किस तरह से बच्चे को परवरिश हुआ है उस परिवार में, और डिसेबिलिटी का सीवियरिटी कितना है. बहुत ज़्यादा डिसेबिलिटी हो तो ऑफकोर्स इट डेफिनेटली अफेक्ट्स द पोजिशन ऑफ द वेल सिबलिंग. And ultimately, what I feel is the most important characteristics is ultimately the personality of the well sibling. That is extremely important. अब हम सबको पता है personality तो एक दिन में नहीं बनता है. It takes years. But that is one focus area that we need to stress on, so that when we focus on the personality of the well being and you know that this is what you can do, so enhancing that personality is definitely going to help him move towards the adjustment and acceptance position. Now for future implications, of course it is, I think it's very obvious, hum log teen hi hai, teen parameters hai. One is the parents, the professionals, the second is the siblings, and the third aspect I wanted to focus on is on capacity building of the siblings, how this can be done and what kind of research we have for that. बेसिकली दिस रिलेशनशिप इज ऑल अबाउट रिलेशन बिल्डिंग. किस तरह से ये रिश्ता को और मजबूत आप कर सकते हैं, और करने वाला कोई नहीं है जो इनके ऊपर जो है माता पिता है या एक्सटेंडेड फैमिली है, दे आर द पीपल हु कैन रियली कन्वर्ट दिस इनटू अ लॉन्ग टर्म रिलेशनशिप बिल्डिंग प्रोसेस. और ये है लॉन्ग टर्म, ये एक दिन के लेक्चर के बात नहीं, एक साल के बात नहीं है, छः महीने के बात नहीं, ये पूरे जिंदगी के बात है. पर आपको एक हैबिट बनाना जरूरी, हम सबको एक हैबिट बनाना जरूरी है, दैट वी नीड टू ब्रिंग देम इनटू द लाइमलाइट. सम ऑफ अस हैव ऑलरेडी डन दैट, लेट मी नॉट बी डिसरिस्पेक्टफुल टू देम, बट वी नीड टू कंटिन्यू डूइंग दैट. सो द इंडिविजुअल रिकॉग्निशन टू हिम, टू हिज डिग्निटी, हिज रिस्पेक्ट इज वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. आई थिंक द एग्जाम्पल दैट आई गिव यू अबाउट द लिटिल गर्ल वॉन्टिंग टू नो वाई हर ब्रदर वॉज बिहेविंग दिस वे एंड हाउ द मदर रिस्पॉन्डेड, दैट इज गुड इनफ प्लेस टू स्टार्ट फ्रॉम. And encouraging them for their little efforts, and of course keeping them informed. ये keeping them informed मैंने इसलिए डाला है, बहुत सारे situations हम देखते हैं जहाँ family में elder sibling आके reassessment के लिए request करते हैं या कोई documentation के लिए request करते हैं. जब हम पूर्ण उनसे पूछते हैं कि आप बताइए पहले क्या क्या हुआ है, क्या क्या ट्रीटमेंट प्रोटोकॉल या इंटरवेंशन क्या हुआ है वो बताइए, दे हैव एब्सोल्युटली नो इन्फॉर्मेशन, नो पेपर, नो रिकॉर्ड्स, नथिंग ऑफ दैट सॉर्ट. सो कीपिंग देम इन्फॉर्म्ड आई थिंक इज अनदर वे टू ग्रूम देयर कैपेसिटी टू बिकम इफेक्टिव केयर गिवर्स. Then for professionals, I do not know whether I'm the right person to talk about how professionals can make a difference, but for my profession, I feel that encouraging ourselves in the ITPs and the IEPs that we make is definitely a very, very positive way of bringing the siblings into the mainstream. And of course, encouraging parents and helping them to prioritize when the well sibling should be in focus and when he should not be in focus. That is one way that I feel is important. What about the well sibling himself, जिसके ऊपर ये सारे बातें इतने सब कुछ हो रहे, उसके ऊपर कुछ नहीं है, उसका क्या रोल है, उसका कुछ तो रोल बनता होगा. Now like I've said, I do not know how many well siblings are here, but it would really be good to have a separate interaction to understand where they stand in this entire continuum. The only way I feel that the well sibling can really make a difference based on the interaction that we've had is, first of all, the general awareness about what is happening all around you. That's really important. Jo isse matlab hai ki aapke apna career building, apna padhai, apna laksh jo hai wo set tay hona chahiye. They need to be guided. It's not that you are living and working only for your sibling with special needs. Yes, definitely he is important, but you are also equally important. and also collecting information from parents. There should not be fear or hesitation about collecting information from parents. And lastly, of course, what I'm always emphasizing on is the needs fulfillment. Whose needs fulfillment? Not the child with special need, the sibling, the well sibling. Your own needs fulfillment is extremely important. I'm just leaving, I will not talk much in detail in these two, but I'm leaving this for the benefit of the parents that there is something called a Legal Guardianship Act. Jinko pata nahi hai, isko aap zarur search kare. This is one access for you to ensure that when your sibling, your well sibling is ready, when you feel that he wants to take the responsibility, you can appoint him as a legal guardian, which will be effective in the period that you are not here. When parents are no longer here, the siblings will take over as official legal guardians, legal caretakers. Caretakers to hai instinctively, but ek legal sanction bhi zarurat hai. Isliye maine ye site छपवा दिए इसमें जिसमें आप जाके आप सर्च कर सकते हैं. प्लीज अंडरस्टैंड द इम्पोर्टेंस ऑफ द लीगल गार्डियंस एक्ट. कई रिसर्च है जो इसमें ये जाहिर होता है कि जितने ज्यादा आप ये रिलेशनशिप के ऊपर आप इन्वेस्ट करेंगे उतना ज्यादा आपको मुनाफा मिलेगा. सो दैट अल्टीमेटली योर फैमिली इज अ हेल्दी वन. यस अनुपमा.
No, ma'am, go ahead, please.
Yeah, I'm intentionally not going for the polls because I think we'd be good to go towards the end. It's almost done because we need to be fair to the participants as well. Here, I would like to introduce this gentleman who's been working for more than 2 decades now in the area of sibling support. His name is Don Mayers. Or agle slide mein unka maine details mein dali hoon. Aap zarur search kare last ke link mein. He is basically the founder of a very interesting project called Sibling Support Project. This is based in US, and interestingly, he has got this online workshop. Aajkal to sab kuch online ka fashion ho gaya, to ye bhi kyun puche chute. He has done online workshops in 8 countries, mostly in the US and Europe, and also in Japan. Jisme online support group ke madhyam se ye log workshops organize karte hain, jisme sirf sibling इन्वॉल्व है. और मुझे इससे ध्यान आता है 14 साल पहले जैसे हम आपसे कहा है हम लोग एनिपिट के एक स्कूल है लाजपत नगर और नोएडा में भी. एवरी ईयर वी यूज टू हैव अ वन सिबलिंग ट्रेनिंग प्रोग्राम वेयर वी यूज टू इनवाइट ओनली द सिबलिंग्स नॉट द पेरेंट्स एंड द चाइल्ड विद स्पेशल नीड्स. दे यूज टू हैव एन इंटरेक्टिव सेशन वेदर इट वुड बी आर्ट और डांस और ड्रामा. दे वुड हैव लंच टुगेदर एंड that was how the event was wrapped up. But that was a real eye opener. Bina training ka, bina instruction ka, sibling jis tarah se apna special needs sibling ko support karte, that was an amazing experience for us. So this is something similar to that, lekin farak itna hai ki unko training milta hai ki kis tarah se kya type ka preparation kare aise bachcho ke liye. So there were three different levels are there. One is the SIP teen. SIP teen is involving only the teenagers, not the 18 ke niche wale jo age group hai, usko involve karke workshops karana apne special needs bachcho ke sath mein. SIP 20 is those who are above 18, to unko involve karke alag alag विषय पे डिस्कशन हो रहे हैं. जिस तरह से पॉइंट्स मैंने आपके सामने रखा था शादी के बारे में, फ्यूचर कंसर्न्स के बारे में, एंजाइटी के बारे में. और आखिरी उन्होंने इनिशिएटिव किया है, ही हैज स्टार्टेड ऑनलाइन कम्युनिटीज फॉर यंग एडल्ट्स ब्रदर्स एंड सिस्टर्स व्हिच अलाउ ऑल सिबलिंग्स फ्रॉम ऑल ओवर द वर्ल्ड टू इंटरैक्ट विद ईच अदर एंड टू कनेक्ट विद ईच अदर. सो देयर ऑलमोस्ट 3,000 पीपल वर्ल्ड वाइड ऑन दिस काइंड ऑफ अ नेटवर्क एंड ही ऑल्सो डज अ लॉट ऑफ वर्कशॉप्स एज़ वेल. But this is one thing which really impacted me, and I felt we can actually take it up not as research but more for action research, because this is the right time to be having online groups. We are already functioning with online groups. Usme mere khayal se koi harz nahi hai ki is cheez ko hum aage bare, aur mujhe bahut umeed hai that there's going to be tremendous amount of quality that we can impart through this kind of initiatives. Another aspect is of course the research aspect, because until and unless you don't do research on this, you are moving on basis of presumptions ki aise hota hoga waise hota hoga. So it's a request for the professionals and of course to myself and my team that we need to get into more research. Very very small research is enough, and I'm sure the parents would never hesitate to contribute to this research.
I'd like to end my presentation here with another request for a poll, just to sort of get connected, and another very, very genuine request to all the participants to please go back and think of the reflective questions that we have put up. Anupam.
Yes, ma'am, we are starting the poll again.
Thank you.
Ghosh ma'am, you are there?
Yes, very reassuring. The poll results are very reassuring. So happy to see.
Meantime, while the participants are doing the poll and they may want to modify their options of the previous
poll. Yes, yes.
So we can take questions along.
Right.
Ma'am, there's a question that in the post-COVID era, when we yes. observe there's a shift towards the blended learning, it also creates inequality in terms of the availability of learning resources. So how can we include CWSNs in this scenario with blending learning approach to impart the quality education?
Okay, this is something that I've been worrying about right from the time the lockdown started, and we've been all going gaga and excited about having e-learning. And when you say blended learning, from what I understand from blended learning, it's a combination of e-learning and other forms of learning. Am I correct?
Maybe ma'am, please proceed.
So I'm saying that blended learning, when you say blended learning, you're basically referring to combination of e-learning and other forms of learning. Am I correct?
Yes.
Yeah. So my answer to this is, I really do not have an answer to this, except one point which I've been asserting repeatedly in many webinars, is unless and until we really boost up our digital base and our mobile usage utility and our laptop utility and gadget utility, it's really not going to be that effective. I'm sorry to say. So, but I am hopeful that even if we boost that a little, it is the issue of equity and equality is going to come up when you handle the situation in families. And essentially, I believe it is up to the primary caretakers to find a way to ensure that kind of an equality.
Ma'am, there is another question that if the well sibling decides to get married and yes. also take care of the special needs child, so yes. how can the sibling manage the balancing attention for the child and the spouse? And what if it becomes tough? Then we thought in the first place and be some of the solutions for a smooth transition.
Yes, it's a very valid question. I'll be very happy if it comes from a parent. See, as far as marriage is concerned, I am of the opinion that yes, it is possible to have a marriage and it's possible to balance the well sibling as well. It all, I feel, Anupama, really depends on how you have groomed the child in the growing years. See, this entire process is not a one day affair. It's an entire life's affair, but it's a question of developing an orientation. So if I want to look at it very ideally speaking, if I see that the child with special needs is groomed appropriately for family living and is groomed appropriately to make sure that he has a busy and occupied routine, I really see no harm in the well sibling getting married and having a family of his own. The trick of the matter now is to orient his new family into the needs of the special sibling. It all depends on his commitment. If he's committed and he decides he wants to remain committed, it's for him to include his partner or her partner in the entire process of commitment. If he feels that is not possible, then he will obviously have to find a situation where he finds, yes, it's really difficult to have him staying in the old home, in the same home, which is highly unlikely if he's well trained. Then he can, of course, look for another alternative option where he can look for a home. But the principle and the practices that we have seen, the best form of rehabilitation is not in a home. It's where he is inside, staying in a family and having a family lifestyle. So it would be in the best interest of everybody involved to work towards this commitment and gradually orient the new persons in the family towards the care of the special. It needs to be mutual. It's not as if you are always caring for him. He's also got to be taught how to play his role as a responsible family member. And I've seen that happening in many places.
Yes, ma'am. The next question comes in the flow of the previous one. That what if, in case the sibling is not ready to take the responsibility of the special sibling, and especially when there is single parent. And as a professional, what can be done in such a scenario?
Single parent. I'm sorry. The sibling. You mean when the sibling is
when there is a parent is a single parent, and there are. Siblings, but the other sibling, the well sibling, is not ready to take up the responsibility of the special sibling. Then how can we guide, or how can we move forward in such a situation?
It's very difficult to take a decision. It's a decision they'll have to take for them. If they can, at the most, do a pilot study and find out whether the sibling can be asked to stay separately in a home or something of that sort. Another alternative is for the well sibling to again move out of this primary setup if he's not comfortable, and find a setup of his own. Here I would like to make a point. Indian culture is all otherwise very positive, but sometimes there is a sense of dependence in Indian culture. In the West, you see it is an understood thing that once a person is 18 years old, he's got to move out of his primary home and he's got to find a place of his own. And the parents are least bothered how he does it, because they know that they're going to find a way to do it. So in the same thing, if I generalize now, it is expected that an adult with a disability can also probably move out into a group home. But the group home concept is yet to catch on in India. So keeping that in mind, this particular family will have to find probably what are the best choices. The choices that I can see is having move out into homes. Again, homes are very limited in number. Or ask the well sibling to move out into a separate residential accommodation and expect the mother to be the caretaker. But ultimately, he'll have to understand whether he likes it or not. He will have to be a legal guardian of this particular child involved, because the court is going to ask that also. That is as far as the paperwork is concerned.
Indeed, very valuable suggestions that you have raised.
I don't know how valuable, but I'm sure you can also contribute.
We will be taking one last question here, that how to cater a child in classroom if suffering from any cognitive problem, not able to understand all the things.
I'm sorry, can you say that again? In the classroom?
How to cater a child in the classroom if suffering from any cognitive problem and not able to understand all things?
That's a general question. Can I ask Amrita ma'am to take that up, or Shilpa ma'am? I think it's basically related to special education.
Thank you, Mrs. Ghosh. I think it is related to the cognitive problem. So definitely first we have to do the assessment of the child with the help of professional. And if we are talking about the role of siblings, so definitely sibling can teach, sibling can give some opportunity to maximize their ability to learn. Because many of the time we have seen that environment can have an important role. So this can be done. So cognitive problem first should be addressed properly with the help of professional, and then we can advise.
And ultimately, when the program is made, we make an effort to involve the sibling in the activities as much as possible.
Sometimes what happens, we imitate our elder siblings. All in a, even in a normal process, we copy, we try to model there, you know, in academic and in even in other behavioral options. So if the child is having cognitive problems, so first we have to go with the proper assessment, and then we can help. Definitely we can help, and we are using this resources, like we give some instruction during our parent training program, during our sibling training program. We try to give some sort of important key factors to the siblings, so that the other child who is having cognitive problem, they may minimize this thing.
Thank you so much, Amrita ma'am, for guiding us with this question.
One thing I wanted to add, one thing, we face problems in the sense that the well sibling has to attend school and he has his own assertive activities. So sometimes what happens, the interface with the well sibling becomes very difficult for professionals, but that is not the case with parents. So that is something that can be taken over. That is a limitation that we professionals have.
But that now need not be a limitation that parents would be having.
Ji, ma'am, of course, that is a limitation to this. And now we have with us Dr. Hemant Keshwal, sir, Assistant Professor, Special Education with the NIPED Regional Center, Noida. I would invite sir to share his remarks over this topic of today's webinar. Sir, please.
Yes, you can.
So you may please provide us with your valuable remarks in the chat box area, because the audio, you must be in the view mode. The audio permissibility is not at our end. Very sorry, I guess there is some technical glitch going on. By this, we have nearly come to the end of the today's national webinar. I would like to extend the deepest thanks to the eminent speaker of the day, Mrs. Shabri Ghosh, ma'am, for taking out time and sharing the knowledge and expert advice with all the participants who are there today. Again, I would like to extend, on behalf of NIPED RC Noida, would like to extend our sincere thanks to the director, ma'am. To the Deputy Director, sir, NIPED, for giving us the opportunity to present today in front of all of you. I would extend my gratitude to the Honorable Officer in Charge, Dr. Amrita Sahai, ma'am, for giving us the opportunity, and Mrs. Ghosh, this opportunity to share her expert in front of all of us. And great gratitude and sincere thanks to Shilpa ma'am, Rahul sir, and the entire team who has been coordinating and putting the efforts in bringing up this webinar for you all. I would also like to extend the deepest thanks to the RC Noida team, all the faculty members, and all the support staff for constant support and making all the arrangements to make this webinar possible. Over to you, Shilpa ma'am, and deepest thanks to you all for managing this so well and giving us this opportunity. Please, Shilpa ma'am.
Thank you, Anupama. Could you please make an announcement regarding the feedback form and the certificates?
Yeah, as far as the feedback form is concerned, we shall be circulating the feedback form to all the attendees over here. And we would request you to take the next two or the maximum 3 days to fill up the feedback form, send it back to us, and that will help us to generate the certificates. Of course, we request little more time for the certificate generation. So hopefully by the end of the month, we should be able to send certificates to everybody. I hope that was clear.
Yeah, thank you. And I would like to tell to all the participants that some of you are saying that why don't we use Zoom? So let me make an announcement over here that we have the orders from the central government of Ministry of Information and Broadcasting that Zoom has a lot of privacy issues and a lot of data is being gathered by the Zoom and without any permissions from the users, and the use of Zoom has been very discouraged. So we at NIPED are not using Zoom for reasons of privacy breach. Okay. So for those who wish to attend the Zoom, I'm sure that there are many programs and webinars going conducted in Zoom. You may attend because it is up to you, the choice of deciding which platform you have to use. But as for NIPID, we are using Zoho platform, which is an Indian software developed by the Indians, where the data is all managed in Indian centers, also trying to encourage the Make in India concept. So thank you one and all. If there is anything else from Anupama?
Ma'am, there's a suggestion that has come in from somewhere asking whether there's a sibling training course provided by NIPID online for 3 to 6 months that will allow the well sibling to handle a special needs sibling. I would just like to respond briefly to this. This is an excellent suggestion. Maybe in the coming months we can conceptualize something like that. But as of right now, the online support groups we're already having for parents are doing tremendous work, and primary credit goes to the sibling. So in a manner of speaking, for the time being, that itself is providing very valuable training to the siblings. I just wanted to give that information.
Yes. We do not, even at NIPID headquarters, we do conduct sibling training programs every year in the summer vacation time, because that's when most of the siblings would be free. And we do conduct a 5-day training program, but it is not an online training program. It is a face-to-face training program. But now, because of this situation, I think we can take up the suggestion of having an online training program for the siblings also. So once again, please, participants, please make note that the feedback form will be sent to you, within 1 day. That is tomorrow, you will receive your feedback form. And after you receive your feedback form and fill it up, please give us 1 week to 10 days time to send you back your certificates. There was also a question regarding whether this webinar will have CRE points. Let me tell to the participants that no, this program is not accredited with any CRE points.
Thank you once again, ma'am. Thank you one and all.
Thank you again, Shilpa ma'am, and of course, valuable thanks to the director, deputy director, and all your team in the headquarter, ma'am. You've been a great support. Thank you.
Click the exit button to leave the webinar. We end the webinar over here.